Scientists have not been successful in pinpointing the precise position of the radio waves as of yet, but they believe neutron stars, which are formed from the collapsed cores of enormous stars, may be the source of the waves. According to the researchers, the signals have been appearing consistently and can last for up to 3 seconds at a time. The duration of a typical fast radio burst, often known as an FRB, is merely a few milliseconds. According to a statement released by MIT, inside this window, the team identified bursts of radio waves that repeat every 0.2 seconds in a clear periodic rhythm, comparable to a beating heart. According to a statement released by MIT, researchers working at the Dominion Radio Astrophysical Observatory in British Columbia on December 21, 2019, were able to detect a signal that could be associated with an FRB. Danielle Mashili, a postdoctoral researcher at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology's Kavli Institute for Astrophysics and Space Research, described the phenomenon as, "Not only was it very long, lasting about 3 seconds, but there were periodic peaks that were remarkably precise, emitting every fraction of a second, boom, 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 like a heartbeat. Not only was it very long, lasting about 3 seconds," she said, "but there were periodic peaks that were remarkably precise. We can now confirm that the signal itself is periodic," the researcher said. The researchers might use the data on the bursts, including their frequency and how they change, depending on where the source is located in relation to Earth, to establish the rate at which the universe is expanding. After the unveiling of the first photos of the universe from the James Webb Space Telescope, earlier this week came the announcement about the repeating radio waves. These photos show that the formation of some galaxies took place more than 13 billion years ago. Now it's time to look at some other amazing and mind-boggling findings. The beginning of time. One of JWST's most lauded capabilities is its ability to see into the early universe and view some of the first galaxies and stars. Already, the telescope, which launched on Christmas Day 2021 and is already 1.5 million kilometers away from Earth, has discovered the most distant and earliest known galaxy. When two teams independently reviewed JWST images for the GLASS survey, one of more than 200 science programs planned for the telescope's first year in space, they discovered the galaxy. Both teams, led by Rohan Naidu of the Harvard Smithsonian Center for Astrophysics in Massachusetts and Marco Castellano of the Astronomical Observatory of Rome, identified two particularly distant galaxies in the data, one so far away that JWST detects the light it emitted 400 million years after the Big Bang, tying the oldest galaxy ever seen by the Hubble Space Telescope, and the other, dubbed GLASS Z13, seen as it appeared 300 million years after the Big, it would be the most distant galaxy ever discovered, Castellano said. Both galaxies appear to be extremely small, approximately 100 times smaller than the Milky Way, but they exhibit astonishing rates of star formation and contain 1 billion times the mass of our Sun, more than predicted for galaxies this young. One of the newborn galaxies even has a disc-like shape. More research will be conducted to dissect their light and discern their properties. Another early universe investigation, the Cosmic Evolution Early Release Science Survey, has discovered extremely distant galaxies, according to Rebecca Larson, an astronomer at the University of Texas at Austin and a member of the survey. Only a few weeks into the study, the team has identified a few galaxies from the universe's first 500 million years, though Larson and her colleagues have yet to announce their exact findings. "It's greater than I could have hoped for, and it's only the beginning," she remarked. More early galaxies are hidden in the image of President Biden's galaxy cluster, which Pascal and Mahler investigated. The cluster, known as SMAX 0723, is so massive that it bends the light of more distant objects, bringing them into view. Pascal and Mahler discovered up to 16 distant galaxies that have been enlarged in the image. Their ages are unknown. Structure of the galaxy. JWST has already delivered valuable data to scientists aiming to understand the structure of galaxies and how stars develop within them. Janice Lee of the National Science Foundation's NOIR Lab in Arizona leads one observing program that searches for youthful sites of star formation in galaxies. JWST saw, on behalf of Lee's team, NGC 7496, a galaxy 24 million light-years away, whose early star-forming regions had previously been covered in darkness. Hubble's instruments were unable to penetrate the heavy dust and gas that surrounded these regions. JWST, on the other hand, can see infrared light that bounces off dust, allowing it to explore near the moments when stars turned on and nuclear fusion occurred in their cores. "The dust is literally lighting up," Lee observed. "What's most amazing," she says, "is that NGC 7496 isn't a poster child galaxy. However, it suddenly springs to life under the watching eye of JWST, revealing channels where stars are emerging. It's really incredible," she exclaimed. Meanwhile, John Barentine, an astronomer at the Arizona-based Dark Sky Conservation Organization Dark Sky Consulting, found a more accidental discovery in one of JWST's first photographs. The image of the Southern Ring Nebula, which is 2,500 light-years away from Earth, was exceptionally clear. A fascinating galaxy viewed edge-on, a unique vantage position for examining the galaxy's core bulge, popped into view off to the side, earlier misunderstood as part of the nebula itself. Keeping an eye on the stars and planets. Smaller targets, including planets in our own solar system, are also in JWST's sights. Jupiter emerged magnificently as part of the initial batch of photos captured in a 75-second exposure. Astronomers understand that Jupiter's top atmosphere is hundreds of degrees hotter than its lower atmosphere, but they don't understand why. JWST was able to view the heated upper atmosphere gleaming as a red ring around the planet by detecting infrared radiation. "We have this layer a few hundred kilometers above the cloud decks that is glowing because it is hot," Henrik Mellon, a planetary scientist at the University of Leicester, explained. "On a worldwide basis, we've never seen anything like this before. That is a wonderful sight." Mellon's group intends to employ JWST in the following weeks to investigate the cause of this atmospheric heating. The volcanic moon Io interacting with Jupiter's aurora, causing a slight bump in the aurora, is hidden in JWST's view of Jupiter. According to Mellon, the image shows material arriving from Io running down the magnetic field lines. The effect had previously been observed, but JWST detected it with a single glance at the planet. JWST is also looking for planets in other star systems. The famous TRAPPIST-1 system, a red dwarf star with seven Earth-sized worlds, some potentially habitable, has already been observed by the telescope, though the data is currently being evaluated. Early observations of a less hospitable planet, a hot Jupiter termed WASP-96b, in a 3.4-day orbit around its star, have been released. JWST discovered water vapor in the planet's atmosphere, confirming previous evidence of water obtained by Chima Magruder of the Harvard Smithsonian Center and colleagues using a ground-based telescope. However, by analyzing WASP-96b's carbon-to-oxygen ratio, JWST may be able to solve a baffling puzzle concerning hot Jupiters, how they achieve such close orbits around their stars. More oxygen indicates that the gas giant developed close to the star, whereas a higher carbon ratio indicates that it evolved in more carbon-rich regions further away. Meanwhile, JWST may have seen a transitory light in the sky which was not originally planned to detect. Mike Engesser, an astronomer, and colleagues at the Space Telescope Science Institute in Baltimore, Maryland, the JWST Operations Center, observed a bright object not visible in Hubble photographs of the same location. They believe it is a supernova, or exploding star, 3 billion light-years away, proving that the telescope can detect such events. JWST should also be able to detect far more distant supernovas, giving it yet another ability to serve as a probe of the early cosmos. It may also discover stars being ripped apart by supermassive black holes at galaxy centers, which no previous observatory had discovered. "We'll be able to peek into these really deep, black regions for the first time," said Ori Fox, an astronomer at the Space Telescope Science Institute who leads the team investigating transients. And that brings us to the end of the video. Feel free to let us know what you think about this video. And if you like this video, then please leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more amazing content.